I'm going to talk about triangle, about common mistakes, a common problem, and a fix for it. So look, the common triangle is explained like this. From here, please, a regular setup would be like this. Where he's low, I control his head, he's completely low. I control his elbow and his head. I fix my arms to this one over here. Control the wrist. I start pushing the wrist inside in my hip. I show it from another angle straight away. Now, if I wait from here, and Andreas starts pushing himself up, help your shoulders, Andreas, so don't keep where you were. Push your shoulders to the ceiling. Yes, I can put the foot on his hip, bring my hip up, and start closing. From here, the regular approach to put the hip up, put the elbow to the other side, here. Step over the shoulder, close the triangle, get the head, and choke from here. I'm going to show the same thing from the from this angle. Okay, so we're low. I control his head, I control his wrist. If I push his hand to the inside, this elbow decides my success. I cannot step over the elbow, but so here I would usually wait until the person on top recovers his posture. No, the same as before, put your shoulders to the ceiling, yes. I push, step on the hip, step over, catch, bring my hip higher to bring the elbow free, bring it over to the other side, drop, block the shoulder, close here. Get the head and bring up. The problem with it is, look, so this I can do. It's a possible setup. Now, the first thing I need, if the shoulder is free and he can bring the shoulder out and bring the arm back, I will suffer. That's the first problem with this setup. The second one, if I manage to do this and I catch the head and I start pulling it, Andreas starts stacking me, please. See? Keep going. Now it turns into a battle. A little bit less, please, because we have to be able to talk. Now it starts to turn into a battle of endurance, because I'm uncomfortable, he's uncomfortable. He may be slightly more, but like many people, keep running straight away, please. Go 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. Most people will be have to open their legs on that point. So the fix for this was in the past to put your arm underneath the leg here in the leg, please. Keep him out of balance, and yes, here I can finish the triangle. Go back to keeping him on 4. The risk, however, whenever I catch the leg, is that he in MMA could knock me out or catch my head. It starts questioning me now, please, shoulder on my face, and often this leads to a pass. Now this triangle setup still works. If you do it with lighter people, it still works, and if you grind your teeth and bite to the uncomfortableness of the stack. Now the next fix was this, to bring the same setup for triangle, close the triangle, arm goes underneath the arm and close your own knee. And this was good for many years as well. It works great for people who don't stack. Try to run away, Andreas. That's great. Yeah, I can perfectly stop this. Stack me. I can compensate by turning, but still, it's still a risk if he catches my head. So the fix now for the whole thing is this. So I'm not going to talk about the setup itself, but about the actual triangle. Put your butt low, please. Well, two things. Whenever I close a triangle here, look, the first thing I do, I will never close my triangle straight away. The moment I close the triangle, he can immediately start the stack. Go up. Yes, go back. So what I have to do here, I always need to keep the foot on the hip. If I have the foot on the hip, try to come forward, Andreas, I can stop him from coming in, I can stop the stack. I have pressure on this by arching my back and putting my shin into the air. Push forward. Yeah, great. Let's go a bit backwards, please, for the camera. Here. So now, we're here, and I don't even bother about the arm anymore. The first thing I want to do is to keep his hip away. Now look at this leg. It's always about the mirroring principle. If I move first, he will win. If I step over here and I go for inside first, then he has the advantage of walk around, catching my head, and now I lose the hip. And now there's a big chance of me losing the hip entirely. So what I prefer to do in the beginning, imagine it like this. Imagine like this here, look, put my leg over, see? And he puts his hand on the floor, and stretch your arm, please, here, and I want to move my foot out. I would be making this move to scoop out and to go around. Come back, please. I'm going to do the same pressure on my knee. Once I'm here, see, I'm going to actually make him control the neck, control the arm, squeeze my knees, open this foot, and squeeze like that. See, now, Andreas, walk around on this side, please. Can be done, my foot is stopping it. Stack me, please. Can be done, because my foot is stopping it. So, go back to the middle. Leaves me one option, is walking around on that side. If I open my knee here, See, try to walk around Andreas, he walks around, I bring my shoulders to the same side, he walk, and once he's where I want him, then I close and I catch him. Sometimes the arm, the leg, sorry, sometimes the arm, depending on where I have the space. Stick me now, please. As long as I keep my hip on the floor, it should be very hard. If I raise my hip, stick me again, please, I'm in trouble again. So, okay, here, go back down, please. So now the best part of it, look, this is still the regular triangle, the setup for the regular triangle. Squeeze the knees, open the foot, block all directions until he walks to the side where I want. He walks around, other side Andreas, yeah, walk around, step, I catch. And I have a decent triangle as long as I keep my posture correct, chin up, arching back, and especially hip on the floor. Now the better triangle is this, or I don't know if you should call it, but it's a triangle technically. Look here, instead of going to this, what I prefer to do these days, it doesn't matter anymore where the arm is, but the arm can be here. Let's start, for easy explanation, put the arm in the correct spot, but it doesn't matter, as I will show later. Look, first of all, when I put the same posture as before, Andreas, run forward please, I will stop this part, relax a little bit, yeah. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to use my foot on the floor or on the hip, depending on how you feel, and put pressure on my frames, I'm going to hip escape around him. This is the same thing as I'm doing for the hip escape from cycle. All I'm doing here is I'm lift my hip a little bit, see here, and now scoop my inside hip under like a technical setup, like a hip escape, like this. That's the angle I want. Come back, please. So here, I block his shoulders, his arms, stop please, post the foot. As I frame my arms, I'm going to lift my hip escape around and go for a side triangle, I suppose. It's very important to keep the calf inside the neck and step over here. My heels turn towards my face. The more I turn my knees towards, my toes towards my nose, the more danger for my knee there is a frame I have. So I turn the foot out and now I step over here. First of all, again, chin up, arch your back. I don't need even my arms anymore to block in here. If Andreas runs forward, I can stop it. He runs away, I can stop it. Stand up, Andreas. I can turn and I'm in a good spot. Go back, please. Later, more about that one. So here first, I need to make him uncomfortable. So I'm going to squeeze. And it is technically possible to make a choke here, although a bit hard. So the first one I'm going to go for is go for the Americano. Catch the pink, lift the arm, bring it to my chest. Make sure it's tight. Keep away my hip and my frame. And then start putting pressure on the arm and shoulder mostly. Now, if Andreas wants to defend this one, he's going to stand up and follow his arm where it comes from, brings me to a perfect spot, the triangle. If he leans away, I can go, don't fall please, just go back please, just come back, lean away a bit, I can step over, arm bar, or just finish the triangle, go back. So again, the position here, you post, hit the scape around, hit you towards you, step over, and squeeze. You catch the arm, go for a triangle. Don't move. And go for the Americano. Usually they will start, when they get smarter, they will start hiding the arms. So switch your hands, please. Yeah. I cannot reach it. Now the important part. This is the most difficult part here. Look, if I'm here and I start squeezing, walk towards me, Andreas, and you get more of a choke. So you're usually going to circle out on that side. Circle out this way. Yeah. Should I roll over like this? That's why this technique, I think many people don't use it because I'm afraid of this. When you start to roll here, get your head out, Andreas, usually you will lose the technique in that way because your grip starts to get weak. Come back, please. So, you're gonna fix this. It's actually an easy fix. You flip the shape around, you catch, and you squeeze, keep your, very important again, chin up, arch your back. When Andreas starts to walk around, I'm gonna go halfway to my knees here, close the hands, and I'll push him back over. And this is the nastiest of all triangles, just catch the leg. Turn, and now, from here, look away and turn your level. I'm going to turn this hip to the ground here in this case. So I'm turning in, and this puts a lot of pressure on his neck. Obviously, you can also finish with arm bars, and there's maybe even options to start attacking the legs here. And why are we doing it? From here. The last one, from this position here, look, if I'm here, if Andrea starts walking away, so a circle, circle around, yeah, the previous one, and circle over, great. He knows what's happening. So he starts walking forward, he starts walking back where he came from.
I wait for it. Starts running forward. Every time he runs forward, see? Go continue. Because on this side, he puts himself straight away, my knee foot on my back, and then straight into the position to finish. Now the beauty of it is this, look, in the past, when we had a regular, go to the middle. In the past, when we had a regular triangle, I always have to make sure I clear the arm to the other side to be able to do a choke. Now in this case here, because of the configuration of the hip and the balls, doesn't matter anymore where the arm is. The arm is here, great. I can hip escape, do not move me. I can hip escape around. Well, hip escape around, squeeze it from here. Still have a good choke. I can do the opposite. I can hip escape around here to the same configuration and get the same choke here. Let me the other options would be a bit different because here I would start to have to put a lock on the shoulder to bring the elbow in. Kind of like an Americana, I suppose here. Tight, put your hip in. Go back please. And slide backwards because you're not too close to the camera. Come here. And those other options, it completely doesn't matter anymore where the arm is. It can be here, it can be here. I can choose even which side I escape. I can hip escape around over here, which would be my preferred one in this case. I can even choose to ignore it altogether and go to that side. Completely doesn't make any difference. I'm always on the side, which is hard for me in this case, and I can attack the arm. And the reason it works better is the same thing as all chokes. Chokes, with an exception, well, you don't have to close the side of the neck. You don't have to close the side of the neck here. So if you go around the throat, this is very nasty. Well, this won't work because we go to the sides. But usually, Ezekiel's arm triangle, they come from the side. So in this case, because, come here please, if I hip escape, I put my calf into his neck, and that's the reason the choke works better. Try it, let me know if it works in the comments. Thanks.